Good evening, the jury members and everyone watching the presentation. I'm Aarti from Savita Dental College. I'm pursuing oral pathology first year. So my topic today is child abuse. The World Health Organization defines child abuse and child maltreatment as all forms of physical and emotional ill-treatment, sexual abuse, neglect or negligent treatment, or commercial or other exploitation resulting in actual or potential harm to the child's health, survival, development or dignity in the context of a relationship of responsibility, trust, or power. So there are many forms of child maltreatment, including neglect, physical abuse, sexual abuse, exploitation, and emotional abuse. Next slide, ma'am. So studies say that neglect is the maximum number of child abuse faced, which is about 34%, and the next two is the sexual abuse, followed by physical abuse, and lastly, the emotional abuse. Next slide, ma'am. The types of child abuse include infanticide, child labor, breast ironing, child marriage, child trafficking, forced adoption, female genital mutilation, sexual initiation of virgins, violence against girl students, gender-based violence against girls, violence against children with superstitious accusations. Next slide, ma'am. The signs of the child abuse are unexplained changes in behavior or personality, becoming withdrawn, seemingly anxious, becoming uncharacteristically aggressive, lacks social skills and has few friends, if any, poor bond or relationship with the parent, knowledge of adult issues inappropriate for their age, running away or going missing, always choosing to wear clothes which cover their body. Before moving on to the next slide, I would like to add that various studies have proved that 70% of all the physical injuries in abused individuals are located in the head and neck. So dentists are more likely to be confronted with related abuse injuries. So injuries can either be observed intraorally or extraorally. So dental professionals have a major role in this aspect and thus help in the investigation of all abuse cases. Next slide. So after from all the signs and the symptoms, the last and the most confirmed resort is moving on to the DNA forensic. So how does a DNA forensic help in the child abuse? There are various areas where we can actually collect the samples and various methods of collecting samples. So we can collect it from the oral cavity, urine, saliva, hands, vaginal vestibule and anus, hair, nails, semen, etc. In the oral cavity, we can collect the DNA from kissing. We have to avoid toothbrushing and astringent wash and get the sample as soon as possible and recover the evidence using dry cotton swab technique. From the urine, the DNA is collected from the genital tract. Put urine in a sterile container and keep it refrigerated until the analysis. Saliva, we can collect it over the skin, bite wounds, kisses, and other kinds of oral contact. Recover the evidence using slightly moist swabbing and double swabbing technique. Avoid washing or having contact with the other object. DNA from the hands, or this from the entire palmar surface of each hand. To protect the DNA, wrap the entire hand, recover the evidence using moist swabbing, avoid washing, and do not let any contact with other objects or textiles. Vaginal vestibule and anus, sperm cells from the clitoris, frenulum of the labia minora, labia majora, and anal rectal and perianal region. Avoid washing the perianal region, recover the evidence using swabbing. Hair, pubic hair of the aggressor can be collected by combing the area and recover the samples in clean envelopes. Nails, DNA from the hypernicium of the area can be collected and you can use it through swabbing and cut the nails of each hand, pack them in separate envelope. So semen can be collected and avoid washing and do not let any contact with other objects or textiles. DNA from the surface of the penis, prepuce and scrotum, recover the evidence using swabbing. Vagina vault, we can collect from the fornix, cervix and vagina and recover the all the evidence has to be recovered as soon as possible using dry swabbing. So with this, I would like to conclude that dentistry has much to offer law enforcement in the detection and solution of crime proceedings. Teeth with all their physiologic and variations and pathosis and effects of therapy record information that remains throughout life and beyond. Dental professionals have a major role to play in keeping accurate dental records and thus providing all necessary information so that legal authorities may recognize malpractice, negligence, fraud, or abuse, and therefore identify the unknown humans and help in controlling child abuse. Thank you.